Illusion not too shabby with the culling either, so we can see a lot of long range pressure, and the final pick gonna come through for Albus Noctluna will be the Vladimir in the mid lane for Kira. Thinks it'll work well up against the Jace in the mid.
Yeah,
I think Rox actually came out ahead here.
Well, yeah, Smurf. Feb is the...
This is the taunt. Goes back for the trade again. Sayo's looking for to get hit for damage, and he might bring him down. Smurf flashes, gets away from the buckshot. But here comes Peanut over the wall, looking to find the slam. Gets it now. The taunt's not going to mean much. And gets himself first blood, and here's the chase. Jumps over the wall. Good rappel. The taunt's going to land in the curl, though. How much more do they have?
He's down.
The last little bit in, and it's two kills for Albus Nox. Circle landed it. But here comes Rox. Yep. Coming down. Good bubble on Illicrit. He's not in a good spot at all. Here comes the rappel trying to join in, but he's not going to land the cocoon. Peanut's not going to get it. Oh. Going to chase into the turret curl. The turret shot. It's going to be a trade kill. One for one for the Rome.
Kira needs to push mid lane now because he was left there and he's
hurt. But he is his jungler.
Taunt's not going to be it for now, but he's going to ult again. He's in range. They really want to pick off Smeb. The taunt's going to get in a second. Not quite into the turret just yet. A miracle going to get stunned up. And look at all the damage output. There's no chance to turn it around off the smallest of windows with Licorice just not in range. A great dive and a great kill for Rox Tigers.
Yeah, here with the Doran shield early. It's hard to take down some of these tanks. A lot of damage here from Koro onto Kira.
Again, not a lot of CC left though as Kuro is running away. Ghost is on. Kira gets some decent damage, puts the pool down for a slow, and that means Graves is in range. Kuro does not have the ability to get out, and that is a kill for PvP Stayhost. Albus Nox keeping it up
well for them as he starts to head bottom lane. Bardolph doesn't land, but
they land on the Gorilla into the root, into the damage output, and the crit gets the kill. Out the goes with the Magical Journey. Prey actually forcing him out 1v3, but tempered fate, sadly. Just a quick dodge out. And Rox Tigers able to slink away pretty easily. Smurf out of his lane, getting
Kira
killed.
Back. Oh, he ghosted also. That was both summoners. They're going for Peanut.
Looking for the play out of him. He's going to land the top flash. They're going to get the damage with Hemo Plague. And Kira does get himself the kill. Smeb cannot join for 20 more seconds. Looking now for the play. Can they get it? The culling actually not going to land much from Bray. He's clearing the minion wave away. Kira runs out of health and actually gets popped out. And now Kuro's joining the battle as well. Stayhost still gets the first kill, but trades his life for it. This is going better and better for Rox Tigers as Bray is chasing down to find some of his own. The quick slow trap's gonna get him out of range. Feb can join. The Cypher Kuro turns it around. And
now once again, Licorice has his ulti ready on this bard here. He missed the two ultis he's used so far. Now it's the Tigers with the TP advantage.
Smurf cannot join. A beautiful equalizer. And here come the kills. The kills are just that now. 7-7. And Feb is still on the chase. Good dodge in the bubble. Stayhost not gonna lose his life just yet. But a 2-0. And that is efficiency. That is a solid, great game.
Quick two kills, but they're not out yet.
They're not, but it's a 5v3. This is still dangerous, but Albus Nox really wants anything here. Stayhill's gonna clear a bit of the wave. Kira getting sniped and doesn't get a chance to pool or anything. Another beautiful kill by Rox Tigers as Kuro clears the wave. Three in a row so far that have missed their mark. Rox Tigers continue the mid lane seats. Med missing an ultimate, but who cares? Kuro can still land all the snipes. Kira going in for the dive, looking for damage on a Peanut. Gonna dodge the shock blast as well. Who are they gonna find? A quick taunt in from Smurf. Kuro low on HP. A great stun's gonna land, and Kira getting himself the kill. That's 1-0 so far to Albus Nox. They keep the turret alive as well. Nicely played.
Yeah, what a nice engage and great coordination. Chaining that CC onto Kuro. Had a few seconds on this flash here. Couldn't escape. Mid lane.
Oh, another chase in. What? That was over aggressive. Albus Nox chose that fight and they lost their life. No kills.
Up to defend. Smurf stays alive. Normally when you play Shen.
The cocoon into the equalizer. And all the damage they could possibly need. A flash chase by Peanut gets the kill.
The Vicio confirmed. Not time traveler. Not able to predict. Here we go, though. Stayhost
play. A nice bubble. Hits the Graves. Not going to find much more just yet, though. The chase in. Dodges to flash away from the roof. But how much more can the re-engage really do? Licorice running out of HP. He's going to go down. Stayhost going to be next. And Rox Tigers continue to win fight after fight. 12-8 the kill score now. Again, between 10 and 20 minutes, they are explosive. You're seeing it once again right here. The chase out of the turret. Kira, 1v1 against Prey. And Prey comes out victorious. 6-0.
Lane's pushing towards ANX's base here, and then the rest of the Rox Tigers can just keep hitting these turrets here as a group.
Looking for the Gorilla. Gonna land a bit of a stun on a Gorilla. They're looking for it now. Kira into the back line, finding with the can, but wow, Prey is gone like he's already picked off the Bard. Now the dive in the back line, but they've killed off Prey. Smeb top of Zonya's Hourglass. Gritty kills back and forth. Low HP on all sides and an overdive by Rock Tigers. They've lost three. Now Kuro's in the mix, looking for more with Peanut. Smurf now trying to trade it back. It's only one member alive for Albus Nox.
How you gonna get out?
Did get a bit more. Now Gorilla on the trade. Nice dodge on Cocoon. One more attack will do it. Smurf gets himself the kill. Chased down by Peanut. And it's the last man standing. Rock's his newest player. They're just
looking for the push.
Who's flanking who?
Who he's gonna find. And now he's gonna get a little bit surrounded. E-Cluster comes in looking for a miracle. Gets the shuttle, but gets blasted anyway. There's the kill picked up. No damage coming across. 2-0. Kira likely to be next up on this one as Speb Kite's back. Prey in a battle with Smurf. Just no damage really dealt on either side as the dodge zone drops off. There's the kill on the Smurf. That's going to be 4-5 kills now picked up for Rocks Tigers, the ace in front of the base.
Getting the Baron is super, super important.
Yeah, I think if it were 35 minutes in, you'd see them try to end the game instead. But the recall's fast enough, the respawn, I should say, fast enough by Albus Nox, they'd only get the inhibitor and force the recall. Health bar down a little bit more. Baron buff minions come in now to the mid lane. A nice stun on the Sejos. He's got to get away from this one. Kira to re-engage. Puts the pool. And he's going to deliver Shen into the back lines. Can they do enough damage, though? Is Peanut going to tick down with the Hemo Plague? Staying alive, though. No stun on the Prey. And the re-engage still. Prey wants in. Oh. He's going to find one. Dives in for a second. And he just will not take any damage. That's the triple for him. Kuro takes one of the other ones. And now Smurf will fall. It would have been a Penta. But scumbag Kuro steals it away. But that is the ace inside the base. That should be the game for Rocks Tigers to start their tournament 1-0. The tournament favorites stomping everyone in front of them, turning it on after 10 minutes and laying waste to Albus Nox. The synchronized emotes ends game one. Congratulations, Rocks Tigers, 1-0.
Great to see them turn it on after 10 minutes when we had some good fights in the bottom lane. Sadly for Albus Nox, they could not execute when they had the global advantage, end up losing kills. And then suddenly Rox had the advantage, had the summoner spells, and just forced place after place after place, and were able to outplay the opponent.
That really is where they lost all of their momentum, in that bottom side, trying to get a little bit too much. But Rox Tigers, you know, confident showing here, and moving up to tie CLG, as Freak was questioning.